Today on The Brief, amidst all the recent political turmoil in France, a glimmer of hope is emerging thanks to the feverish, high-tech activity going on in the southern regions of the country. From quantum startups to robot manufacturers, France is doing its part to develop innovative solutions for the betterment of humanity. Over the past 2 years, neuroscientists, surgeons, and biomedical engineers at the Clinatech Research Center in Grenoble have been working with a tetraplegic man to develop robot limbs interfaced with his brain. The patient, a young man named Thibault, has been trained to use an exoskeleton that runs on bioelectrical signals. These signals are captured by two recorders implanted in his skull in order to move his arms and legs and rotate his wrists. The setup works much like an IoT system, where models running on separate computing resources are used to decode the brain signals and actuate the exoskeleton. But this innovation didn't happen overnight. The turn of the century was a critical inflection point in industrial history. It was a golden age for robotics. Factories all around the world were meeting stringent quality requirements by implementing sophisticated machinery supported by complex sensory networks. This brought about the rise of context awareness. We're now at the start of a new phase in the information age. Smart machines are not just performing repetitive, difficult work with minimal errors, they're also improving the performance of humans by providing complementary assistance. In Industry 4.0, the performance of robots is improved by the presence of humans, and vice versa. In fact, we're seeing collaborative robots in all sorts of work settings, and they're evolving into symbiotic robots. Thibault cannot move without his exoskeleton, and his exoskeleton cannot move without his commands. For more on this, check out our upcoming Tech Trends Report for 2020, and join me at Live Las Vegas, where I'll be speaking about symbiotic robots and more.